This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. In this video, we're going to discuss the signs of the trig functions in the various quadrants, whether they're positive or negative. So we're only talking about an angle that is up here in a quadrant, not ones on the axes. Right? So in the first quadrant, both x and y is positive, right, in the ordered pair. In quadrant 2, the x value is negative, the y is positive. Quadrant 3, x value, the x coordinate is negative, and so is the y coordinate. And in the fourth quadrant, the x coordinate is positive, and the y coordinate is negative. What's most important is to know whether the x coordinate or the y coordinate is positive or negative in each of these quadrants. Now, so this will tell us whether the x or y value is positive or negative, and then the other value in the trig functions is r. So r is always positive, so keep that in mind. So let's see, in quadrant 1, if I wanted to get the cosine or the sine, I'm going to end up putting a positive number over r, right? So it's going to be positive. The tangent will be the y over x, so it'll be a positive over a positive. And then, so for the sine, cosine, and tangent, they're positive, so all the reciprocals will be positive. So all of them are positive. All the trig functions are positive in quadrant 1. Okay? All right, let's think about what's going on in quadrant 2. Well, what about the sine? The sine will be the y value over r, so it's going to be a positive number over a positive number, which means it's positive. So the sine of an angle in quadrant 2 is positive, and so its reciprocal will also be positive. How about the cosine? The cosine is x over r, so it'll be a negative number over r, so it's going to be negative. Remember, r is always positive. And so its reciprocal will also be negative. And how about the tangent? The tangent's y over x. Well, I'm going to have a positive over a negative. Well, that's negative. So its reciprocal is also negative. So notice that the sine and cosecant are positive. I'm just going to do the sine because that is the one that is the most important one. Remember, cosecant is just a reciprocal. So we've got definitely that of the three main trig functions, the sine, cosine, and tangent, sine is positive. All right, let's do the same thing down here in quadrant 3. What about the sine? Well, it's a negative number over r because the y is negative here. So here the sine is negative, and the cosecant then will also be negative. How about for the cosine? Well, x is negative. Negative over r, right? Negative over positive is also going to be negative. And so the secant, its reciprocal, will be negative. And what about the tangent? The tangent is y over x. So a negative over a negative is positive. So its reciprocal will also be positive. I forgot to put alpha here. Remember, you always have to put the cosecant of something. You can't just, I did it up here as well. Easy to make that mistake. There we go. So always have to have an angle after that abbreviation. All right, so the cosine and the sine and the cosine are both negative, but here, of the main trig functions, it's the tangent. Tangent and cotangent are positive. Okay, let's go over to quadrant 4. The sine is negative because the y value is negative. So the sine is negative, which means the cosecant of alpha is also negative. Cosine, right, is a positive number over r, so that one's positive, which means the secant is also positive. And the tangent, y over x, is negative over positive, so the tangent is negative. So its reciprocal is also negative. So that tells me that of the main trig functions, only the cosine is positive. Now, one way I remember this is I just pay attention for the sine and the cosine. I just pay attention to the x or the y value. So if I look at in this order pair, in the first quadrant, everything's positive, so they're all positive. But in the second quadrant, x is negative, so the x goes along with the cosine, so the cosine's negative. And y goes along with the sine. Here, y is positive, so the sine's positive. Down here in quadrant 3, they're both negative, so both the cosine is negative and the sine is negative. And in quadrant 4, x is positive, so the cosine is positive and the sine is negative. So I associate the x with the cosine and the y with the sine. And that's because, of course, cosine is x over r and sine is y over r. Okay, so look at what I've got here. If we go around from quadrant 1 to 4, all are positive. In the second quadrant, the sine is positive. Third quadrant, tangent is positive. And in the fourth one, cosine is positive. And people remember this. They think all, sine, tangent, and I'm going to move this a little, so a little more space. Sorry. There we go. And get rid of that little yellow thing. ASTC. So you could remember all sine, tangent, cosine, but what a lot of people remember is a little mnemonic, all students take calculus. All are positive. Students, you associate that with a sine, so only the sine is positive and it's reciprocal, of course. Take, T for tangent. Tangent is the only one that's positive in its reciprocal function. Calculus, C for cosine. So this is what it looks like. And that's a little mnemonic. People remember. So if that is helpful to you, you could think about it that way. All students take calculus, so all of the functions are positive. This is where they're positive. All are positive in quadrant 1. S, only the sine and cosecant. T, only the tangent and cotangent. C, only the cosine and secant. So if it helps you to remember that, you can say all students take calculus and get that. I don't do that. I just always think about the signs. So I just think about this being negative and positive. So I know the cosine is negative, the sine is positive. That's how I do it. All right, but it's up to you. So that's some other little trick you can use if it's helpful.
This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.